Detroit and the nation's capital to face the Redskins. They should have stayed home. Three. It's off a Rodney Pete pass, leading to one score. Mark Rippon finds Jimmy Johnson all alone in the end zone for another. And when running back Ernest Biner decides to throw to Ricky Sanders, the rout is on. 35-0 by halftime. Skins crush Detroit 45-0. Monday Night Football. Monday Night Football, Washington at Dallas. Troy Aikman at Dallas had three touchdown passes. This one 5 yards to Emmitt Smith, who scored twice. Aikman completed 27. His team led 21-10. For Washington, Mark Rippon had a great game. This 37-yard pass to Art Monk for a score. Rippon had two touchdown passes. His team trailed at halftime 21-20. Star of the game, though, the Washington kicker, Chip Lohmeiler. Four field goals, 53, 52, 45, and 46 yards. The last one turned out to be the game winner. Final score, Washington 33, Dallas 31. Mike's 17-14. Joe Gibbs Redskins back at home against Phoenix. Ricky Sanders on the reverse follows quarterback Mark Rippon's block into the end zone. Rippon hooks up with Gary Clark. A wide open Gary Clark. After a pump fake, it's six more. Skins linebacker Wilbur Marshall punctuate a dismal day for Cardinals quarterback Tom Tupa by intercepting him and go the distance. The Redskins hand the Cardinals their 13th straight loss in Washington and stay on top of the NFC East. Bears Redskins Chicago, things up for grabs. Ronnie Morris of the Bears makes a spectacular circus catch. Not yet. Look at this. Whoops. Bears quarterback Jim Harbaugh was manhandled by one of the best, Charles Mann of the Redskins. Mark Rippon, he hooks up with Art Monk, 26 yards, and it's 10-0 Washington. And the Bears come back. As Neil Anderson flies high, it's 10-7. Harbaugh has his pass first deflected by Eric Williams and then picked off by Fred Stokes. Then, under very heavy pressure, Harbaugh attempts to throw the pass away. But Kirk Govia steps in, and it's another Bears turnover. Then later, Rippon finds Monk again, 17-7. The Redskins stay undefeated, beat up the Bears, 20-7. Highlights of the other games from Week 7. The Redskins are on the warpath. 12-year veteran Art Monk beats Browns quarterback Frank Minifield on this play, making a great catch to tie Charlie Joyner as the number two all-time receiver. Monk passes Joyner in a big way, catching this touchdown pass from Mark Rippon in the corner. Trick play from Cleveland. Webster Slaughter, top right, part of the screen. Pretends to leave the field on this Matt Stover field goal attempt. It's a fake. Holder Brian Hansen throws to Slaughter. Browns touchdown. But the Redskins iced the game on a 65-yard TV scamper from rookie Ricky Irvins. Over 100 yards on the day, Washington 7-0, 42-17. The Saints. The undefeated Redskins invade Coach Ray Handley and the Giants. The Skins have lost six straight in Giants Stadium. New York goes for some razzle-dazzle early. Jeff Hostetler flips one to Stephen Baker, who scampers 52 yards to set up a Giants field goal. Rodney Hampton rages again as he blows past the Redskins for 12 yards and then soars over the top for the New York touchdown. Talk about heartbreak. Mark Rippon tries to catch up, throws this pass perfect to Gary Clark, and guess what? Oh, dear. The Giants lead 13-0 at the half. Rippon to Clark. This time he gets it. 13-7. Giants. Rippon bombs. This one to Clark. TD. A field goal, and it's Skins 17-13. The Giants. One last chance. Hostetler. Throws. Nope. Picked off by Wilbur Marshall. The Skins, the only undefeated team in the NFL, win it 17-13. The undefeated Washington Redskins shooting for the 10th straight win. A career day for Mark Rippon, who hits Terry Orr for the first score. Then, Rippon to tight end Gary Clark. a 61-yard hookup, and before you know it, it's 14-3 Washington. And when Rippon, who threw for 6 touchdowns, couldn't pass, he ran, and he did it well. This bootleg, well, it meant another 6. Time to go to the veteran Art Monk, and the Redskin Art Slaught continued. Back to Gary Clark. Gary Clark, he had 4 catches, 3 touchdowns, 200-plus yards on the day. And the defense, well, they did their part, too. Linebacker Andre Collins, he picks off this pass, and after a little bit of a juggling act, he takes it in. Washington crushes the Falcons 56-17. 49ers Saints, what's up in Pittsburgh? Steelers Mean Joe Green hopes? Nope. Mark Rippon to Art Monk with a little help from the official. Down to the 1. Then, it's Rippon to Monk again. Both feet are in, folks. 14-0 Redskins. Watch this tremendous one-handed grab by Gary Clark down the right sideline. Steelers rally, though. Neil O'Donnell to Dwight Stone, 27-14 Washington. But there is no stopping the Skins. Rippon back to Clark again. Washington becomes the earliest team since the 85 Bears to clinch a playoff spot, 41-14 over Pittsburgh. Redskins, Rams, it's been a tough year for Rams coach John Robinson. He watches Mark Rippon connect with Terry Orr, 7-3 Skins. Hair-pulling time for John when Flipper Anderson is stripped clean by the Skins' Wilbur Marshall. Washington recovers the fumble, and that sets up this Mark Rippon to Ricky Sanders 30-yard touchdown strike. The Redskins again, a screen pass. Ricky Irvins takes it in. Joe Gibbs Redskins roll to the NFC East title, 27-6.
That's empathy.
Here's Vinny in Washingtonville. Vinny, how are you today?
I'm a very disappointed and very confused Jet fan at this point.
It's truly been a season of sorrow for sports fans in New York and Los Angeles. The hometown teams in both baseball and football have fallen on hard times.
You know, everybody seems to think that because there's so much money around, that the big market teams will always hoard the talent and monopolize the talent, and it never works that way.
It's a very sad state of affairs. I mean, you have major league teams in this town are on page 3 in our paper now.
Big Apple baseball fans spent the summer watching the Mets and Yankees race to stay out of their respective cellars. Then there was hope with the arrival of football. The Jets were perfect in the preseason. Since then, they've been perfectly awful, 0-4, hardly living up to expectations.
Well, you know, when you're in the media capital like New York and L.A., you know, expectations are high. Everybody's watching these teams in those particular cities. So it's a little tough.
It really doesn't get any worse than here in the land of silver and black, where the Raiders are suffering through an 0-4 start. If you go back to last season, they've lost 8 games in a row, and that's the Raiders' longest losing streak in the past 30 years. Now, Al Davis may have coined the phrase, just win, baby, but around here these days, they're thinking, just win one, baby.
They're just like I am. They're wondering what the hell is going on. What's wrong with this?
They got to get better because they can't get any worse.
When you lose on the field, you lose at the gate as well. Fan attendance in New York and Los Angeles has dropped off sharply.
Who wants to go sit into a stadium and watch the pathetic Raiders lose?
Attendance is down for most of these losing teams when you compare the figures with their last winning seasons. Fans stayed away in droves when the Raiders played their only home game so far this season. Attendance down 24%. In Anaheim, the numbers are off even further, down 28%. In New York, football fans have remained loyal. So far, neither the Jets or the Giants have suffered at the gate. But not so for the baseball crowd. The Mets have been down 32% in 92. The Yankees are off 35%. In Los Angeles, the Dodger drop was 22%, and the Angels are off the same compared to their last winning season. While the fans have been staying away, this sports futility continues to be the talk of these two cities.
It's really getting frustrating out here. Really frustrating.
Baby, every week.
Just lose, baby.
And there's always waiting till next year.
Then Harbaugh, on a quarterback option, drops back and goes right up the middle, does it himself, it's a touchdown. On Minnesota's next possession, Rich Gannon throws long to Anthony Carter, but it's intercepted by the Bears' Lemuel Stinson. And that's how the game stands. One quarter to go, Chicago leads 20-0, resulted in the punt. We pick up play.
The outside and down at the...
Roger Craig hurtling to the wall. Touchdown, Minnesota!
5.
The Chiefs and Broncos at Mile High in Denver. KC quarterback Dave Craig unloads to Willie Davis 50 yards. Davis rolls in. The Chiefs lead 19-6. But late fourth quarter, John Elway guides the Broncos 80 yards. The final 25 to Mark Jackson. On the ensuing kickoff, Dale Carter at the 1. Mistake. He goes cross field. Alton Montgomery tackles Carter at the 4. Broncos hold. KC punts. Arthur Marshall fumbles it, picks it up, and then races 28 yards, almost breaks it, down to the Chiefs' 27-yard line. Elway trying for his 21st fourth quarter comeback, hits Marshall for 10. Then, second and 5 from the 12th, 43 seconds left, Elway to Vance Johnson, touchdown. Johnson was activated just before the game, and Elway looks for him right away, all the way. 6 for the Broncos. The Chiefs are not done. Craig to Davis, right down the middle. Davis is leveled by Dennis Smith. Ball at the 50. Craig throws incomplete on a slant to Emile Henry. Then fourth down, it's complete to J.J. Burton. But it's short of the first down. Denver shocks Kansas City 20-19. The Rams go north to Candlestick to face the 49ers. Jim Everett dumps one off to tight end Pat Carter, and we're tied at 7. The Niners' Steve Young drops back, throws, intercepted by Robert Bailey. And Bailey sidesteps his way to the end zone. The Rams lead 17-10. But Young again shows his versatility, scrambling up the middle 8 yards to tie the game at 17. It's Young again, and watch this. 4 minutes left. Young, who passed for 247 yards and ran for 60 more, goes 39 yards and a final stiff arm to give the Niners the lead. But back comes Everett and the Rams to Flipper Anderson. 9 yards, and we're tied at 24. A minute and a half left in the game. Young hits tight end Brent Jones over the middle, 42 yards, and it sets up with 5 seconds left on the clock, a 21-yard Mike Cooper field goal. San Francisco holds off the stubborn Rams 27-24. The Redskins invade Phoenix to cage the Cardinals. Already 7-0 Washington, and Ernest Biner doubles the lead early in the first quarter. Now 24-6 Redskins. Mark Rippon drops, throws. Robert Massey picks it off. Down the right sideline. Touchdown, Phoenix. Deja vu, folks. Massey again steps in front of a Rippon aerial. End zone again. Phoenix within 4. Now Cardinals ball. Chris Chandler fakes to the right. Throws left to Larry Centers. Centers crashes in, and Phoenix leads. Chance to tie. The Skins chip low middle, 5 seconds left, 40-yard field goal, no good. Joe Gibbs beaten by ex-assistant Joe Bugle. Phoenix stuns the Skins 27-24. It's the Colts and the 3-1 Buccaneers in Tampa. It looks easy early. Vinny Testaverde to a wide-open Stanford Jennings. Where's the defense? 7-zip Bucks. The Colts' Rodney Culver busts in from 2 yards out to tie it 7-all. Tampa Bay back on top after this. Reggie Cobb shake and bake right up the middle. Not for long, though. Jeff George back leading the Colt attack. Goes up top to Jesse Hester, and we're tied again. Then George to tight end Kerry Cash. Great catch. Colts cash in. Upset the Bucks 24-14. Two dome teams, the Saints and Lions at the Pontiac Silverdome. Detroit coach Wayne Font says, go up, go down, go out, just get open. And Brett Perryman follows orders and hauls in as Rodney Pete pass for the touchdown. 7-3 Lions. But the Saints defense made Pete pay all day. 6 sacks, this one by Ricky Jackson. Then it was Wayne Martin's turn. And Martin liked it so much, he did it again. And when Vaughn Dunbar scores New Orleans' first rushing touchdown of the year from the 2, it leaves Font pondering a 1-4 start for his underachieving club. Saints stuff the Lions 13-7. The Packers and Falcons in Atlanta. Spotlight shining on Atlanta's Andre Rison. The catch and a great spin move, 13 yards. It sets up this Chris Miller to Mike Pritchard touchdown strike. Just a great day for Rison. He takes the ball away from Leroy Butler. And ever so dangerous after the catch. Here he makes a great adjustment in the corner of the end zone. Touchdown, 17-0 Falcons. Packer ball, Brett Favre to Sterling Sharp, who steps past Tim McIarr and takes it in. But it's Rison right back, beating rookie Terrell Buckley and strutting his stuff a la Deion Sanders. Atlanta stops Green Bay 24-10. The Giants out west to meet the winless Raiders in an empty, I do mean empty, L.A. Coliseum. Place kicker Jeff Jager, a Pro Bowler last year, can't buy a field goal this season. 10-0 Giants, Jager from 38. No, Jager cannot cope with this. Raiders driving Todd Marinovich to Timmy Brown. Giants quarterback Mark Collins goes for the interception. Uh-uh. Through his hands, bad gamble. Brown sidesteps Renee Thompson. Touchdown, Raiders. Now, 10-10, fourth quarter. Jager from an almost unmakeable 54 yards. It's good. Redemption for Jager. The Raiders chop down the Giants 13-10. Seahawks and Chargers in San Diego's Jack Murphy Stadium. Seattle's Dan McGuire in for the injured Kelly Stauffer, picked off by Anthony Blaylock. It sets up this Stan Humphries to Anthony Miller, 5-yard touchdown strike at the goal line, and the Chargers win their first 17th over Seattle. The Patriots visited the Jets under the lights in the Meadowlands, both teams looking for their first win of the season. Rookie quarterback Browning Nagel got the Jets flying with an 8-yard touchdown pass to Terrence Mathis. Veteran Irving Fryer with the cagey move here after consulting with quarterback Hugh Millen. Fryer limps off and then goes downfield under full speed. He hauls in this Millen pass, 38 yards, touchdown to England. Nagel finished off the Patriots with a 19-yard strike to Rob Moore, and the Jets grab their first win, 30-21 over New England.
And on Monday Night Football, the Dallas Cowboys traveled to the Philadelphia Eagles for the other matchup of the unbeaten. The Philadelphia defense forced 4 turnovers, 3 intercepts, and a fumble. Herschel Walker ran for 2 touchdowns, 1 from the 9, and this one from the 12. Philadelphia whipped the Cowboys 31-7. And those results bring us to these standings after Week 5. In the NFC's Eastern Division, the Eagles with a blitzing win over... including the Super Bowl. Now this year, they've already equaled that loss total. They got 2 wins and 2 losses. Who are they blaming? Mark Rippon. Hero last year, scapegoat this year. CNN's Vince Gillini has found out there's no hog heaven in Washington, D.C. at the moment.
Last January, Super Bowl MVP Mark Rippon was the toast of the town. After 2 Rippon giveaways, good for touchdowns and a fourth quarter collapse at Phoenix, Rippon is being roasted on the airwaves.
Dial up those car phones. It's the Morning Sports Page Beltway Blast.
Mike and Burke, you're on the team. What's your opinion?
I think you should have Mark Rippon playing, obviously starting. Only the thing is, under what condition, you have to give Ricky Sanders, Art Monk, and Gary Clark all Denver Broncos jerseys. Maybe he'll complete more.
Okay. Thanks for the call.
Why is Rippon a marked man and a media target? After 4 games, he has thrown 7 interceptions. He threw just 11 all of last season. This to go along with only 4 touchdown passes. Rippon may be shaken, but not broken.
I've taken these teams to the big one before, and I've fought through adversity, through some tough times. And you know, they measure yourself in those situations, too. I don't think they're going to give up in any sort of way. I don't think I'm going to give up in any sort of way.
Joe Gibbs said he won't bench Rippon, but while the coach is protecting his quarterback, the offensive line at times has not. The Hogs allowed 9 sacks in 1991. Rippon has already been dropped 4 times and pressured on countless occasions. And the loss of center Jeff Bostic to a shoulder injury has the Skins trying to realign the swine on their line.
This line has got enough experience and
People are flexible enough. You're not going to see much of a drop-off. They're just shuffling the cards a little bit and lining them up differently.
The Redskins' path is hauntingly familiar. In 1987, Washington wins the Super Bowl. In 88, the Skins stumble out of the gates at 2-2. Their second loss that season at Phoenix. Their final record, 7-9.
I don't think I thought hardly at all about 88. I think you only think about this year. I don't even remember 88, what happened or anything else. And a lot of these players weren't even here for that.
While Gibbs places little emphasis on the past, at least one Redskin veteran offers a history lesson.
This is the same team we had last year that strung together 11 wins in a row. At four games in, people are already counting us out, you know, and I guess that gives us a little bit more incentive.
The Redskins, from super to average. And with two division losses already, it doesn't take a coaching genius to recognize a club in trouble.
Oh, give me a break. Coach Joe Gibbs.
And someday it will all belong to you. Because you're...
Undefeated Philadelphia Eagles at Kansas City. The run-oriented Chiefs come out throwing. Dave Craig to Willie Davis. First down, Chiefs. Then Craig to J.J. Burton. 13 yards and another Kansas City first down. Then the bomb drops. Craig, pump fake, launches long to Burton, who beats Izell Jenkins, 7-0 Kansas City. The Chiefs were hitting on defense. Randall Cunningham goes down. And then Vi Sikahima cops one. 25 seconds left and a half. Craig to a wide open Burton, TD KC. Second half, long range bombing continues. Craig to Willie Davis, 74 yards and six more. The Eagles rally. Cunningham to tight end Pat Beach. Philly within seven. Last gasp for the Eagles. Cunningham's Hail Mary is picked off by rookie Dale Carter, and Kansas City grounds the Eagles 24-17. Bills and Raiders in L.A. Buffalo, coming off a beating by Miami, falls behind early when Todd Marinovich finds Eric Dickerson out of the backfield, TD. Then Jim Kelly looking for Thurman Thomas. It's tipped, intercepted by Terry McDaniel. He takes off down the left sideline into Buffalo territory, and that led to a Raider field goal. Kelly, under pressure again, sacked by Anthony Smith. He fumbles, and it's recovered by Greg Townsend of the Raiders. Bills driving, fourth and goal. Kelly to Pete Metzlars, knocked down. The Raiders turn some heads and hand the Bills their second straight loss, 20-3. The 49ers versus the winless Patriots in New England. Should be no contest, and it looks that way early. Steve Young, play action fake, dumps over the middle to Jerry Rice. Rice takes off, and of course, TD Niners. But when Hugh Millen lofts one to tight end Marv Cook, the Patriots lead 12-10. That turns into a wake-up call for the Niners. Guard Guy McIntyre with a great lead block for Ricky Waters. Waters rumbles for 30 yards, and it's first down San Francisco. Then Young drops, escapes the grasp of nose tackle Tim Goad, and scrambles 21 yards inside the Patriots 25. Young drops back. He's looking for Rice, but then waits for Waters to break free. TD, the Niners hold off the pesky Pats 24-12. The Steelers and Browns in Cleveland, an AFC Central war. Barry Foster takes the screen pass from quarterback Neil O'Donnell and takes it for a Steeler first down. Then Foster bounces off one, two, three tacklers, and it's another Pittsburgh first down. The Browns' Eric Metcalf says, so what? From the Cleveland 7, he busts out around left end and picks up a quick 31 yards. But then big Kevin Mack powers his way to a Browns first down. They do it with Mack again. This time, a great second effort takes it over the goal line. And when Mike Tomczak goes up top to Michael Jackson, it's the Browns 17-9 over the slumping Steelers. The Giants and Phoenix Cardinals of the New Jersey Meadowlands. Watch fullback Jared Bunch's block on Cards linebacker Eric Hill. It springs Rodney Hampton into the secondary. One good stiff arm, and Hampton goes all the way. The Giants tie it at 7. Then again, Bunch out front with a big block. Hampton is spun around by Tim McDonald. Stays on his feet down to the 20. Then Bunch says, the heck with this, I'll do it myself. And the Giants lead. Jeff Hostetler drops back to pass. He sees an opening. Takes it right up the middle and bounces in. The Giants 31, Cards 21. It's about time. The sluggish Seahawks and the Cowboys in Big D, Dallas. The boys, Emmitt Smith from the one. He's stopped, but a great second effort gets him up and in. That's Dan McGuire, the Seattle quarterback. He gets pummeled, first by Jim Jeffcoat, then next by Jimmy Jones. I think McGuire might rather be Darth Vader. In steps Stan Gelbaugh in relief. Oh no, intercepted right away by Ray Horton. TD Cowboys, Dallas, blank Seattle, 27-0. The Jets and Colts at the Hoosier Dome in Indianapolis. Colts quarterback Jeff George is smashed by Bobby Houston. So in comes Dean Biasucci, tries the field goal. It's partially blocked, no good. We go to overtime. They flip the coin. I've got heads. Heads it is. Colts ball, first in OT. George with a big completion to Reggie Langhorne at the Jets 30. Bring on Biasucci, they say. It's a 48-yarder, and it's good. The Colts win by default 6-3 over the hapless Jets. You wouldn't pay tickets for that game, would you? The bright lights of New Orleans were the setting for this NFC West matchup. Bobby Hebert gave his Saints an early lead with this 5-yard TV strike to Eric Martin. Then it's the Rams, Cleveland Gary. He counters with a 2-yard touchdown run. Then, with the score tied at 10, the Rams were forced to punt, and Marcus Dowell's 28-yard return woke up the sluggish Saints. And that set up Anderson's 30-yard field goal. Ram quarterback Jim Everett. He tries to rally his troops, but after a 13-yard pass to Henry Ellard, Everett was then intercepted by Gene Atkins, and the Saints waved goodbye to the Rams. They beat them 13-10. And in Monday Night Football, the Denver Broncos travel to Washington. Elway versus Rippon. Elway never gets into the end zone. Rippon can't keep out. The hometown critics in Washington are left with egg on their face. The Redskins scalp the Broncos 34-3. Okay, now let's see how this. Dallas and Philadelphia are tied for the top spot. The defending champion Redskins are right on. City Bears meet the Mount Lawley Bengals 3:30 p.m. at the Kingway Olympic Soccer Ground in Wanneroo. You get a 3-point start if you can pronounce 3 out of 4 of those. And just out this week, available at ABC shops, a series of exciting new NFL videos. I'll tell you more about that next week. But today we're going to leave you with a clip from this one, NFL Rocks. It's classic NFL football footage cut to rock music. I hope you enjoy it. Next week, Philadelphia and Washington. Looks like the big game. Here's hoping. We'll cross our fingers. I'm Don Lane. This has been NFL American Football. I'll see you then. I'll keep crossing till we see if we can get that game.
Off Smith, and left tackle pops out to the 30, a block from right, gets him to the 40, breaking right for the 45 to midfield, Smith to the 40,
I don't believe the run,
to the 30, touchdown, Emmitt Smith, 75 yards, thank you very much.
But it's a draw up the middle to Craig, and he breaks loose and runs loose, he gets used to the 30, to the 25, he's down to the 20, breaks loose again, he's to the 10, 5, touchdown 49ers,
the Skins were unable to score TDs. Ollie Jones and Todd Christensen called it.
Mark it at the 8-yard line, so it is second down and 3. It is Gibbons into the end zone. Ernest Gibbons. And there it is. the electric slide. Houston leading 7-3, only the third first down in the ballgame for the Denver Broncos. And here's Gaston Green. He has the opening, breaks it loose. He's to the 40. He's to the 30. He needs a block. He gets the block. There is not a flag. Touchdown. Second and goal to go. Moon throws. It is incomplete. Gibbons was nailed when he was airborne. Could not hang on to it. They cannot change the play. They cannot go to the audible. They have to go with what they call in the huddle because the crowd, the fact that Slaughter cannot pick up the audibles, and he might take somebody else into the other part of the play. Meanwhile, they just give it to Lorenzo White to score the touchdown. And remember what Houston said, for Denver to win, they need only two big plays a game. They almost had one there. Here is another one. They've got it again. Oh, the Lord, it can be a touchdown. Duncan, he is caught at the 9-yard line. Second down, goal to go.
Look for Haywood Jeffries. They have all three receivers on the right. They could be isolating Jeffries to the left.
They play action fake over the middle. It is there. Touchdown. Haywood Jeffries, and Moon celebrates. That's the good news. The bad news, if you're an Oilers fan, is that there's 1 minute and 56 seconds left on the clock, and you're playing right into John Elway's hands. Two plays, 60 yards. First down, Houston 20. Reggie Rivers, Rivers will score.
Same thing, unbelievable.
The line of scrimmage is now the 8-yard line. It is fourth down and 22 with 42 seconds left. Moon is to the 20. He needs 5 more yards to the 30-yard line.
He got it.
He gets it.
He got it.
Warren Moon, 30-yard line. Houston out of timeout. Moon, I'm not sure he's ready for the snap. The pass is complete at the 50-yard line, and the clock is moving. They have no timeouts. They have no timeouts. They've got to spike the ball. If they can get there in time.
Not going to happen.
Runs out.
And Denver wins that one, 27-21. John Elway strikes again. Imagine that, a minute and 38 seconds to go, and he puts him in three plays, and he puts him in. Okay, let's have a look at the highlights of the rest of the games played this week.
The 1-4 Lions, the 4-1 Vikings in Minnesota. Rich Gannon goes up top to AC. Anthony Carter, 47 yards, a great catch, 7-0 Vikings. Gannon fakes the end around and spots Hassan Jones on the fly pattern. Same place, 43 yards, 6-4. Just over a minute left in the first half. Barry Sanders shakes loose around left end, 11 yards, and gets Detroit on the board. Backup quarterback Sean Salisbury hits Chris Carter, and Minnesota pays back Detroit for their lone loss, 31-14. Cowboys and Indians in Dallas, the Chiefs and Boys, and Dallas's Emmett Smith becomes the youngest running back ever at age 23 to gain over 3,000 yards on this 12-yard scamper. Smith also scores the first Dallas touchdown, 7-0 Cowboys. Now 14-3 Dallas, Barry Word powers in to bring the Chiefs in 4. Constant pressure, though, on KC quarterback Dave Craig. Charles Haley, Jim Jeffcoat, Jimmy Jones all get to Craig, and it pays off late in the fourth quarter. Craig looking for J.J. Burton just a little bit late. Ray Horton intercepts. Dallas hangs on 17-10. The Falcons and 49ers at Candlestick in San Francisco. The Niners remember two losses to Atlanta last year. Steve Young back, waving his receivers downfield. Oh, what the heck? I think I'll run. And Young scrambles all the way down to the Falcon 5. It sets up Ricky Waters' touchdown plunge, one of three Waters' touchdowns on the day. End of the first quarter, Young to Jerry Rice, in stride, 80 yards. No one catches Rice in the open. Again, Young to Rice. He evades tacklers. The grasp of Bruce Pickens. And the dive of Tim McKeyer. And then Rice caps a great day on the end around. San Francisco humiliates Atlanta 56-17. The winless Patriots, the unbeaten Dolphins in Miami. Dolphins trailing 10-0 when Dan Marino spots a wide open Mark Clayton, 44 yards and 6 for Miami. Then Marino to his newest weapon, tight end Keith Jackson, 6 yards, 6 more. The onslaught continues. Marino to Mark Duper, who beats Maurice Hurst, 43 yards and the touchdown. Marino, getting pressure, rolls left, Jackson again. And Miami, 6-0 with a 38-17 win. The Chargers and Colts in the Hoosier Dome, Indianapolis. San Diego's Rob Bernstein, happy to be there, 23 carries, 150 yards, and a half gainer into the end zone for a Charger touchdown. Quarterback Stan Humphries launches a floater to speedy Nate Lewis. And Lewis simply runs under it. A great catch at the 10. It sets up another Bernstein touchdown, 14-0 San Diego. Darren Carrington intercepts Colt quarterback Jeff George at the goal line to stop a threat. Then, again, George's pass tipped, Carrington again. And a disgusted George can't believe it. But when George hits tackle William Schultz, Indy is within 3. But San Diego's Eric Bieniemy busts in. Chargers make it 2 straight, 34-14 over the Colts. The Packers and Browns in Cleveland. Browns quarterback Mike Tomczak, off the play fake, throws to Eric Metcalf out of the backfield. And Metcalf dances through the Packers secondary. It sets up this Kevin Mack touchdown burst off the right side, 10-0 Browns. Tight end Mark Barbaro is back in his old bruising style. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 Packers finally managed to bring him down. It sets up another Mack short touchdown. Bill Belichick's Browns down Green Bay 17-6. The Buccaneers visit the Bears in Chicago. And Mike Ditka watches old-time Bear football as Brad Muster crushes in from the 1. Quarterback Jim Harbaugh floats one out to Muster, who casually strolls in. 14-0 Chicago. Late first quarter, Vinny Testaverde to Courtney Hawkins, and the Bears' lead is cut in half. But the Bears break the game open on this play. Harbaugh to Anthony Morgan. 2 Tampa defenders collide, and Morgan is on the way. 83 yards in all. Harbaugh threw for over 300 on the day. And when Sean Gale picks off Testaverde, the Bears bag the win. Chicago bounces the Bucs 31-14. The Giants take on the Rams in Los Angeles, and Ram quarterback Jim Everett is hot. Everett, off a great fake, hits Pat Carter in the back of the end zone, 14-7 Rams. On the ensuing kickoff, Joey Smith flipped head over heels by the Rams special team. Rams 3rd-and-1, and a great fake. Everett to Jeff Chadwick, and the route is on. Cleveland Gary gets 6 more from the 6-yard line. The Giants' Lawrence Taylor is embarrassed, and Coach Ray Henley furious. Rams clobber Giants 38-17. Raiders Seahawks in Seattle. Ex-Raider, now Seattle coach Tom Flores, watches as his rookie quarterback Todd Marinovich goes down under the massive weight of Cortez Kennedy. Marinovich is out for the game. Jay Schrader comes on in relief. And Schrader hits Willie Gault in the end zone. It's 7-0 Raiders. Big bruiser Nick Bell, not much action so far this season, bursts through the initial pileup and goes 66 yards down the right sideline. The Raiders whitewash sorry Seattle 19-0. The Saints and Cardinals in hot, sunny Phoenix. Now, this is the way to watch a football game, folks. Cards quarterback Chris Chandler zips it into Ernie Jones on a slant. The Cards on top early. Bobby Hebert flips to Dalton Hilliard, and New Orleans answers back. And when Quinn Early hauls in a 53-yard touchdown strike from Hebert, it's too late for Phoenix. Saints stop the Cardinals 30-21.
And in Monday Night Football, the Cincinnati Bengals were at Pittsburgh in a freezing minus 6 degrees. Pittsburgh's Dwight Stone went in for 2 TDs, 1 from 30 yards out. A bruised Boomer Esiason couldn't do the same for Cincy. Final score, Pittsburgh Steelers 20, Cincinnati Bengals nothing. And all of those results leaves the standing. This has been NFL American Football. Hey, I'll see you next week.
Probably the most vicious beginning to a football game I've ever seen. You talk about defense that's on a mission.
Helmetized.
Okay, they're just pounding. Stay home this ball game right now. Well, that's mad style football right there.
NFL action.
The resurgent Redskins against the 5-1 Vikings in Minnesota. Washington coach Joe Gibbs exhorts his defense, and it works. Linebacker Kurt Gobea picks off a Rich Gannon pass. It leads to a field goal. Vikings trailing. Gannon hits Roger Craig out of the backfield. Craig down to the 12. Gannon to Craig again, who takes it to the 1. And the next play, Terry Allen goes in. But Mark Rippon finds Art Monk on a crossing pattern, and the Redskins are rolling. Rippon, receivers covered, scrambles to the Minnesota 35-yard line. It sets up a Chip Lowmiller 49-yard field goal, one of 5 on the day for Lowmiller, and it's good. Vikings ball, fourth down, incomplete to Chris Carter. Washington holds off the Vikings 15-13. The Cowboys ride into Los Angeles for a showdown with the Raiders. 92,000 at the usually empty Coliseum. Watch Todd Marinovich go up top to Speedy Willie Gault, 31 yards for the touchdown. The extra point, piece of cake, right? Wrong. Bad snap, Jeff Jaeger flips to Jeff Gossett, who throws into the end zone to Ethan Horton. Almost. It's no good. 6-0 L.A. Emmitt Smith, though, one of his 3 touchdowns on the day. The Cowboys ambush the Raiders 28-13. The Broncos and Chargers in sunny San Diego. Denver trailing 7-0, end of the first half. No problem. John Elway to Mark Jackson, 22 yards. Then Elway once again to Jackson, 32 yards and the touchdown. 7-all at halftime. John Elway celebrates on the sideline, but in the second half, John Elway's nemesis, cornerback Yul Brynner, he's got it. The 8th career interception of Elway. Bird's interception sets up Stan Humphrey to tight end Derek Walker, touchdown Chargers. Denver's possession, Elway's pass is tipped, and you guessed it, Yul Brynner, right place, right time once again. The Broncos down 3. Elway intercepted by Anthony Blaylock. Watch this closely. Blaylock 1 foot in, 1 foot out. Out of bounds. Questionable call, but it stands. Dan Reese's Broncos fall to the Chargers 24-21. Cold war in Wisconsin. Old rivals, the Bears and Packers. Bears coach Mike Ditka looks on as Brad Buster goes up and over from the 2. The Bears lead 17-3. Packers quarterback Brett Favre, he pump fakes and lays it up for Sterling Sharp in the corner. Nice catch, 17-10. But the Bears' Darren Lewis answers that easily with this touchdown run. Mike Holmgren packed, mauled by the Bears, 30-10. The 1-5 Lions go south to Tampa to take on the Bucs. Detroit coach Wayne Fonts with the Union Jack shirt for good luck. Detroit now leads 21-7 in the game. And the Bucs kick off to all-pro returner Mel Gray. He takes it at the 8, cuts right, splits the coverage, and he's on his way. All the way down to the Tampa 5-yard line. It sets up a field goal. Then Barry Sanders. 122 yards of the day, 2 touchdowns, 54 yards here. Lions bash the Bucs 38-7. The Oilers host the Bengals in Houston at the House of Pain. Warren Moon goes deep to Ernest Gibbons, 31 yards for the touchdown, and Gibbons does his electric slide celebration. Leonard Harris gets free, and Moon finds him. It's good for 47 yards. Webster Slaughter with a big first down catch here. It sets up a field goal. Moon to Slaughter again, 36 yards this time, another Houston score. Cincinnati highlights, well, not too many on the day. How about a Boomer Esiason safety? Oilers have the Tiger by the tail. Houston wins 26-10. The struggling Seahawks and the disappointing Giants in New Jersey. Seattle stuns the crowd on this. Stan Gelbaugh to Tommy Kane, 13-yard touchdown, and lead 10-3. Giants quarterback Jeff Hostetler scrambles into the end zone, surviving a savage hit by Rufus Porter. Then Haas hits Ed McCauley in the corner to give the Giants some breathing and some smiling room. Giants stop Seattle 23-10. The birds were flying in Philly. Eagles and Cardinals. Randall Cunningham got Philly on the board first, spotting a wide open Calvin Williams for six. Cunningham also spotted Phoenix defensive back Aeneas Williams. Williams picks it off, and he takes it all the way down to the Eagle 3-yard line, where the Cards' nightmare begins. First down, Johnny Bailey to the one. Second down, quarterback Chris Chandler fumbles into the end zone, and the Eagles recover. But it's offsides Philadelphia, down over. Bailey is smashed by linebacker Byron Evans. Third down, offsides Eagles. Third down again. And again, it's offsides Philadelphia. Third down again, and Bailey is stopped. Fourth down now, and Johnny Bailey stuffed again. The Eagles stop Phoenix 7-3. The Browns and Patriots in New England, 9-0 Cleveland just before halftime, and the Pats, Hugh Millen to Kevin Turner, touchdown. New England down two. Second half, Cleveland's Matt Stover misses a 33-yard field goal. It's wide to the left, and Pats coach Dick McPherson jumps for joy. And when Millen finds Ben Coates from 22 yards out, the Patriots lead 14-9. Under a minute left in the game, fourth and two for the Browns. Mike Tomczak to Scott Galbraith in the corner. Touchdown, Cleveland. Cleveland rallies to dump the Pats 19-17.
And in the Monday night football game, the Buffalo Bills travel to New Jersey to take on the New York Jets. In a tight struggle, Buffalo got back to their winning ways, squeaking past the Jets 24-20. Okay, let's run down the game advantage over the Redskins and the Eagles in the NFC East and NFL American football. I'll see you next week.
In your heart, I see the star of every night and every day.
The Other Side of American Football, a new release from ABC Books, is now available from ABC shops and centers.
And you know
step to me wrong or you fall slow, cause I just wanna kick soul to you. Maybe, maybe take control of you, just like I told you. I wanna roll all the shit that's moving, gonna make you move and groove and leave you like ooh when I touch you. Give you so much of the feeling of the death that I'm dealing when I rub you up and down. You stop picking.
Well, I know it's been a while since you heard a change in a style. So what I'm gonna do is give you something flying new, a change, different from the typical, a bit more than regular, not like the others original. Cause your originality and creativity adding up together equals a BBB posse. Yeah, we out of house, yo, kick it.
Oh no! remain silent.
Two Al Del Greco field goals. Here's how Marv Alpert and former Giants coach Bill Parcells called the game.
And Houston with a 6-0 lead, a 7-minute drive for the Steelers. The 14th play of the drive. Third and goal. And this is a touchdown for Barry Foster.
On the second play of the second half, Warren Moon makes a pass and is hit head-on by Rob Woodson. He's knocked out of the game. Cody Carlson takes his place.
We're told that Warren Moon has suffered a concussion. No word on whether he will. Touchdown! Webster Slaughter with his second touchdown as a member of the Houston Oilers. Second down and 9. Play action. O'Donnell could fire one and he scooped. It is picked up by the Oilers for the touchdown. Ray Childress. Scooping it up and running it in. And Al Del Greco converts and now lead the Steelers 20-7.
Pittsburgh is using Leroy and O'Donnell's going back to the flat shot.
And O'Donnell completes. One play of the drive. The ball is 2.5 yards away from the goal line. Play action, O'Donnell. Adrian Cooper. It's a thick pass. Is flanked out to the left side. O'Donnell looked that way. That goes. For a first down. And it's a first and goal at the 5. O'Donnell again with the play action throw. Green. The tie of the game at 20. The point after. Pittsburgh has come from behind and they lead by 1. 6 seconds to go. 39-yard attempt. Del Greco. So the Steelers over the Oilers, 21-20.
And there's a new for the other games. Here's the highlights.
The 49ers invade the Valley of the Sun to take on the Phoenix Cardinals. Cards quarterback Chris Chandler to Randall the Thrill Hill on a corner comeback. 7-0 Phoenix. The 49ers have Steve Bono at quarterback for an ill Steve Young. Bono is intercepted by Dexter Davis. Davis gets up, travels down the right sideline for a great gain, cuts back in, and runs into trouble. So he decides to lateral to Tim McDonald. McDonald gains more yardage. He spun around and fumbles. But Phoenix recovers, it's their ball. Chandler once again to the thrill. Randall Hill 17-0 Phoenix. Bono completes the tight end Brent Jones over the middle. Jones fumbles. Recovered by Eric Hill, but he's stripped by Mike Sherrard. Touchdown San Francisco, what a play. Chandler answers once again. This time a 23-yard strike to Ricky Prohl. The Cardinals hand the Niners their second loss. Are you sure that's Phoenix out there? They stun San Francisco 24-14. The Miami Dolphins, coming off their first loss, visit their nemesis, the Jets. Veteran Kenny O'Brien at quarterback for New York for the injured Browning Nagel. O'Brien, look at the protection. Finally finds Big Al Toon for the 6. Dan Marino, in his own end zone, is blindsided from the left by Marvin Washington. It's a safety. Rookie Jet tight end Johnny Mitchell is healthy, and what a great one-handed catch. It leads to an O'Brien to Rob Moore touchdown just before halftime. Marino rallies Miami. His pass to Keith Jackson is tipped by Mo Lewis, but caught by Jackson for the touchdown. Then a perfect placement and great catch. Marino to Mark Duper, 6 more. But Cary Blanchard's field goal ices it for Bruce Coslett's Jets. They drown Dolphins 26-14. The Packers and Lions at the Silverdome in an NFC Central matchup. The Packs' Brett Favre to Big Jackie Harris. 15 yards, Green Bay on top early. The Lions' special teams are on the beam. Benny Blades blocks this Packer punt, scoops it up, and takes it in himself for the score. Pack back. Sterling Sharp, one of the truly unheralded great players in the league, goes the distance. Green Bay takes the Lions 27-13. Buccaneers and Saints at the Superdome in New Orleans. The Saints' Bobby Hebert's pass for John Tice goes off his hands right into the hands of Broderick Thomas. And Thomas goes right through the Saints all the way for Tampa Bay. Hebert comes back to Greg Scales, who stretches and makes a great diving catch. It leads to this Dalton Hilliard 18-yard touchdown run. Hilliard powering his way into the end zone, 20-7 Saints. But the Bucs don't quit. Steve DeBerg to Willie Drury, touchdown. Reggie Cobb from 4 yards out, another Tampa Bay touchdown. But Morton Anderson saves the day, 50 yards, it's good. New Orleans squeaks by 23-21. The Rams and Falcons, both coming off a bye week, meet in Atlanta. Fireworks right away. Chris Miller to speedster Michael Haynes. 60 yards, touchdown Falcons. The Rams fight back, though. Jim Everett to Cleveland Gary. Gary improving every week. The Rams now within two. Then Everett finds tight end Jim Price from 5 yards out, and the Rams now lead by five. Billy Joe Tolliver, subbing for an injured Miller, hits Haynes, and the Falcons win 30-28. The Bills host the winless Patriots in Buffalo. A mismatch, right? Buffalo's Thurman Thomas with the ball. He's hit and fumbles. And New England's Vincent Brown picks it up, goes 24 yards. Pats lead 7-0 at the half. The Bills tie it up on this Jim Kelly to tight end Pete Metzelaar's 4-yard hookup. Then Kelly to the ageless James Lofton. 13 yards and six. Buffalo down stubborn New England 16-7. The Colts and Chargers in San Diego, the second meeting in 3 weeks. The Chargers' Bert Grossman meets quarterback Jeff George of Indianapolis in the end zone for a San Diego safety. Stan Humphries floats one to Ronnie Harmon, and Harmon does the rest. Makes some great moves for a very good game for San Diego. It sets up a Humphries to Nate Lewis touchdown, 12-zip Chargers. Again, Humphries to Lewis, 9 yards and six more. Frustrating day for the punchless Colts. The Chargers whitewash Indianapolis 26-0. The Battle of Ohio, Browns, Bengals in Cincinnati. Boomer Esiason finds Craig Thompson in the back of the end zone. It's 7-3 Bengals. Then Rodney Holman, a 5-yard touchdown pass from Boomer, 14-3. Boomer does it again, 24 yards. Tim McGee, 21-3. Browns coach Bill Belichick can't bear to watch or listen anymore. Bengals bash the Browns 30-10. Giants and Redskins at RFK Stadium in Washington. And Washington's Brian Mitchell gets things off right for the Redskins. A 64-yard punt return. Even special team star Renee Thompson can't catch it. The Giants fight back, though, and take the lead on a 17-yard touchdown pass to Ed McCaffrey from Jeff Hostetler. Great defense by the Giants. Lawrence Taylor strips Mark Rippon. Giants ball. Matt Barr ices it with this field goal. And LT and the rest of the Giants celebrate a 24-7 win over the Skins.
And in Monday Night Football, the Minnesota Vikings travel to Chicago in an NFC Central matchup. Jim Harbaugh got sacked 3 times, intercepted twice, once by Jack Del Rio for 84 yards and a TD. The Vikings skinned the Bears 38-10. Well, there's been a bit of movement in the divisions. Let's see how the standings are after Week 9. First, let's go to the National Football Conference. In the NFC East, Dallas stays on top with that victory over Philadelphia. Washington falls into a tie for second with the Eagles. The Giants. American football. I'm Don Lane. I'll see you then.